Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And gentlemen, thank you for your great service to the United States. Let me ask you, General Wolters, the proposed OMB fiscal year 2021 budget requests $705.4 billion for DOD. This represents 0.3% over the current fiscal year. In other words, the proposed budget buys us less resources than the current year, considering inflation. Am I correct there?
Yes, Senator.
And let me just ask you this. Do we need less security resources in the European command next year than we do this year?
Senator, we need more.
And in addition to that, the Secretary of Defense, the Joint Chiefs of Staff, and the National Defense Strategy Commission have all endorsed 3.5% real growth. Is that also your opinion, General Wolters?
Yes, Senator.
And General Lyons, is that your opinion also?
Yes, Senator.
And I appreciate the distinguished chairman mentioning early on in his questioning Rota, Spain, and I'm glad that he and his team visited there, bipartisan delegation visited there just the other day. The DDGs are the workhorse of the Navy. General Wolters, in European command, how does a mere 0.3% increase over the current fiscal year affect what we're going to be able to do there with the DDGs, with the two extra DDGs?
Senator, every cent counts. Those two additional DDGs would allow us the opportunity to continue to improve our ability to get indications and warnings in the potential battle space, and also dramatically improve our ability to better command and control. And because of the flexibility of those resources, they can comprehensively defend in all geographical areas in support of Europe. So those destroyers are critical to improve the campaign to deliver peace, particularly in the areas of indications and warning and command and control.
Thank you for that. And we're going to certainly try to help you, I think, up and down the dais here on a bipartisan basis on the resources that we need to defend America and Americans. It's interesting that the leader of EUCOM would mention in the first few seconds of his statement not only Russia, but China. And so could you enlighten us about where you're seeing increased problems with China and increased influence in the European theater from China?
Senator, two areas. The first is seaport equities, and the second is 5G Huawei. And what we've seen in several critical nations on the periphery of Europe is a economic majority on behalf of China investment for seaports in critical nations like Belgium, Italy, France, and Greece. And that's a large concern to all of the NATO nations. And when you start to do the collective math, you discover that China has access to 10% of the shipping rights into and out of Europe. Those are daunting figures that should lead one to believe that we need to continue to be vigilant with respect to seaport equities on the economic side. The second issue happens to be Huawei and 5G. I'm firmly aware of several European nations who have a tendency to lean towards Huawei and 5G. My concern goes back to the soldiers. Without the appropriate network protection, there's a potential compromise of technical data and personal data, and that is not to the good order and discipline of our U.S. soldiers and our NATO soldiers.
And finally, General Wolters, a number of us have been involved on a member-to-member basis with our parliamentary brothers and sisters in the OSCE Parliamentary Assembly. We have a great new ambassador to the OSCE, Ambassador Jim Gilmore. To what extent is the OSCE organization important to you and to providing you information that you need?
Very important, Senator, and I think it builds incredible trust for the Euro-Atlantic link. Your hearings that you held in Gdansk last year were a huge boost in trust, not only between the U.S. and Poland, but throughout all of NATO.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you.